And now I'm also joined in by Siddharth Sibal, our international correspondent, who's reporting live from Chiang Rai. He's been reporting live nonstop from Ground Zero, bringing us the latest details of the rescue efforts. Let's quickly go across to Siddharth. Siddharth, you know, this is a story of human triumph. After 17 days, the entire football team has finally been rescued. But what are the medical challenges that still remain?
Well, we'll get to know about the medical challenges soon because there will be a press conference shortly. I'm standing in the hospital where the boys are being treated shortly the medical persons will be briefing the media. This will be the second briefing by these medical persons. Yesterday also we saw that briefing in which they briefed about the condition of the 8 boys who were rescued on Sunday and Monday. They said that they're recovering fast, they're stable, and some of them even started to eat food. These boys are on the 8th floor of this hospital and nobody is allowed to go there. Only the first batch of the rescued boys, they are able to meet their parents, but there was a glass wall. But by and large, the next challenge now is focusing on their physical and mental health. Physical, because of the entire difficulty and the structural problems it could have caused on their skeletal system and muscle system, and on the mental part, there is a fear that it might cause a lot of long-term damage, including anxiety, depression, neurological disorders. So that is what the entire team of doctors are focusing on, making sure that the boys stabilize fast, they recover fast, and are back on the ground as they were before this incident took place.
Absolutely, Siddharth. Also, you know, the support has also been, you know, constantly pouring in online. We've been seeing tweets coming in from the U.S. president, also actors like Mia Farrow, and of course, the tech king Elon Musk has also tweeted about his support. So, you know, it's been a global effort, so as to say, what's been the entire contribution as far as, you know, the international efforts are concerned, because this has been one story which has united the entire world.
Well, it has been the story of human and international cooperation, people cutting across borders, across language, across nationality. Last 3 days, we saw the world media descending, people from different nationalities coming together, and they're forgetting their differences. It's one of those few stories that makes the world come together, a story of will and determination, of hoping against hope. And yesterday, we were there at the spot near the cave, and in the evening, when this story came that the boys have been rescued, WION was one of the first one to break the story. It was a scene of jubilation at the center, where a temporary media center has been created. And by and large, it's an international effort. Without this international effort, it would have not been possible.
Right.
We spoke to the US Air Force spokesperson from the Indo-Pacific, who said how the Americans are helping in the entire process. The Indians also proposed their help from a company which helped Bangkok during its flood in 2011.
Right. And now, since, you know, the rescue efforts are finally over, everybody, including the media teams, everybody's been, you know, putting in their level best, waking up day and night. You look so exhausted. So how is the mood like? Are the children finally permitted to see their parents? And how are, how is everybody, you know, celebrating? Are they finally cheering and heaving a sigh of relief?
Well, it's a sigh of relief for everyone, including the media, because it has been a pretty long day, and the place where this cave was located was very far from the city where I am standing. It was almost 1 hour away from the place. There was jubilation because people were literally stranded for many days, but that didn't matter because this was a story of hope, hoping against hope, and it's an international cooperation. But talking about the boys, as I have been telling for quite some time, that the focus right now is on their physical mental health. The doctors will be shortly briefing there, where I am standing behind this place. There is a hall where the briefing will be taking place, where the international media again has descended, because this is a global story. We have been speaking to various journalists from Germany, from Canada, from Australia. They have come in hordes to cover this story, and I have been asking to these journalists, why have they come? They told WION that they came because this incident could have happened anywhere. It could have happened in Germany, India, or Australia. But this is a story of people cutting across nationalities. But I can tell you that the core team involved people from Myanmar and Laos. This city where I am standing borders at the tri-junction of Myanmar, Laos, and Thailand. And as we have been talking, people look exhausted. The media is looking exhausted, but that doesn't matter because it was an endeavor, a human endeavor, people coming across, and that is making everyone work here despite the exhaustion.
Absolutely, Siddhant, as you said, that it's making everybody work over there despite the exhaustion. It is indeed a moment, it's a celebratory moment, since as I said, that you know, it is a story of human triumph. Last but not the least, before I let you go, Siddhant, when can we expect the boys to be finally released from the hospitals?
Well, yesterday when the briefing took place, the doctor said that the first two batches of boys, the four boys who were rescued on Sunday and the four boys who were rescued on Monday, they are recovering very fast. And as we have seen the reports, the coach of the entire team was a Buddhist monk, and he told the boys to do meditation, and that was one of the reasons now people are saying that all the boys survived. And this could be the bravest coach on this planet and bravest team in the planet. And despite the gloom and doom, it's a moment of celebration and jubilation here in Thailand, and of course across the world, because help and anxiety was seen across the world, and this finally this moment has come, and today it's a fresh morning in Thailand and everyone seems to be happy.
Right, Siddhant, also I think it's time for me to actually let you go, because I believe that the press conference where the medical bulletin is supposed to take is already started. So we will come back to you for more details as we continue to track the story moment by moment. Thank you so much for bringing us all those details and working so hard over there in Thailand. Thank you so much.